cool. This video is brought to you by Squarespace, the easiest way to make a beautiful professional website. Visit squarespace.com/makeanything for 10% off your first purchase. What's up guys, it's Devin here with Make Anything, and today's video is a little different from what I tend to do because this project is less about one specific end goal, and it's more about experimentation and sharing my process with you guys. So what I have here in front of me is this table full of 3D printed fabrics, or attempts to create a 3D printed fabric. And this is something that's fascinated me since I got my very first 3D printer, because everything you print on a 3D printer is pretty solid and rigid, typically. Sure, there's flexible filaments, but even those don't flow and behave quite like a fabric or a cloth does, and that's something that I've been trying to recreate. Now, by no means am I the first person to try my hand at creating 3D printed fabrics. There's plenty of users online who have shared their designs for years. Fashion designers have created fully wearable clothing that's all 3D printed. Even NASA has come up with a few really cool models. So that's nothing that I'm trying to claim to do, but I think my own process and approach is something that would be fun for you guys to see. And I'm thinking I came up with some things in different ways, so it's fun to share. I feel like I'm just scratching the surface here, but I decided to share what I have right now just so it doesn't become overwhelming, and so hopefully you guys can come up with some ideas based on what I've done and maybe create your own 3D printed fabrics or give me some ideas of what I can do moving forward. So let me just go ahead and share all of this, starting with my very first experiment that I did way back in 2014. What we have here is a kind of dragon skin chainmail that I was trying to create. All of this is printed in one piece, and I was really trying to avoid support material, and it did work out, but as you can see, there's a lot of space between the scales, and it kind of got tangled up a little bit too easily. So while the idea is pretty cool, I didn't get back into trying 3D printed fabrics until just recently. This fabric consists of these loops printed at 45 degree angles, that way they can all be printed to interlock each other in a single print. And in some ways it was pretty successful. It is super flowy and flexible, it bends quite nicely. However, I didn't have much luck printing this at a smaller scale. The prints tended to fail, and they kind of just lost their flexibility. Also, in general, this fabric didn't feel really nice. It was kind of rough on the skin, and for that reason, I decided to move on and try some different techniques. Here's one that was quite different. Rather than having interlocking pieces, this is just one sheet, but it has these really thin connections between each triangle that allow it to kind of flex. While this was a lot easier to print, it presented a few problems. For one thing, you could only bend it so many times before it just broke in half. Also, because this is a single piece, it behaves more like paper than a fabric in that you can't really do compound curves. You wouldn't be able to bend this over the top of a balloon without it having some wrinkles or bends. Still, it does have some interesting properties. You can bend it in certain ways that might be useful for something that you print flat and bend into its final shape, for example. I'm not sure, but I do think there's some potential behind this idea. Here's another attempt where I was trying to make the most thin, dense mesh that I could. In this case, I ended up printing it a little bit too small, and all the different loops kind of ended up merging together. But as you can see, this is another idea inspired by chainmail, where it's these loops that all lock together. Here it is printed 30% larger, and it was a lot more successful at this size, but it still wasn't completely flexible, but it does create this really beautiful shimmer that's quite mesmerizing. I just kept scaling this model up a little bit at a time until I was able to get it to print really successfully. And here it is printed at pretty much double the original scale on the TiVo Tornado. At this scale, it was finally behaving the way I wanted to. It's super flowy. It feels kind of soft for being a rough plastic, and you can even curl it into a ball and then open it up again, so it's a lot like a fabric. You can see how the loops on the edge tended to spin around and kind of get a little messy, so to fix that, I just printed a rigid border around the whole model. With that change, it makes this really cool tile of sorts that's a great demonstration of this 3D printed fabric. Check out how you can see all my individual fingers and just how well this flows. I also just really like the idea of being able to print something that has both rigid and fabric parts in a single print and a single material. For example, with this thing, I could print some kind of fixture at the top to hang this and build in a light to make some kind of interesting hanging lamp, or anything like that. You can also print any kind of shape, so I made this circular version that's also really cool, and I noticed how it droops down in the middle, so I created some additional parts that you can use to turn this into an interesting, unique bowl. It's nice for holding your keys and wallet, or any kind of small items. It's just pretty different. I like it. Also, it makes music. I would definitely call that test a success, but these next ones are by far my favorite. This is a triangular mesh that I designed, where each triangle has these loops that connect to all the adjacent triangles to create a flexible material. This one was my first test, where I printed it a little bit too small, so once again it lost that flexibility, but it does have this cool shimmer to it, and when I printed that larger, it works really well. I printed this in a few colors, and I also tried some variations, like this version that has holes in some of the triangles, but personally, I like the one that's all solid. I wanted to be able to make really large pieces of fabric, so I created this version of the model where the edge loops are open so that you can kind of hook them together and then stitch them together after the fact using a 3D pen. These pieces here are about as small as I was able to successfully print this fabric, but at this scale, it became very fragile, especially the open loops at the edges here, so I decided to print it a little bit larger, and that made a big difference. You can see how strong it is now. Once I found that perfect size, I printed out a whole bunch of these tiles and started fusing them together. Here you can see me using my 3D pen to close those loops, and I also have this little makeshift aluminum paddle that I made to keep the parts from fusing together. I wasn't sure if I would be able to do it at this tiny scale, but it actually worked out really well, and the loops that I made with the 3D pen hold just as strong as the ones that were 3D printed. Here's my cloth after stitching together 9 of these panels, and at this point it's really satisfying. It flows super nicely, and it's got that same beautiful shimmer that it had earlier. With that working so well, I designed some extra parts specifically for the edges of the fabric. That way you can finish it off, have straight edges all around, and not have any open loops that don't need to be there. Just like all the other tiles, you'll hook them into place and fuse them together with the 3D pen, and here you can see the final product. I'm absolutely thrilled with how this fabric came out. It prints well, it looks great, it feels amazing, it's just really satisfying to play with, and I like the fact that it has this one really smooth side, and then on the other side you can see all the joints and how it actually works. I wasn't sure I would be able to top this, but then I went ahead and printed these really cool patterns. Believe it or not, this was made in a single print without using any 3D pen or anything. It was made using the multi-material upgrade for the Prusa i3 Mark II printer, and this printer only has one nozzle, but it uses a purge block to blend between the different colors so that it can get really clean 4-color prints. Up top, there are 4 extruders, one for each spool of filament. And those are all fed into the single hot end. All it takes is a special G-code to make sure that only one color is fed in at a time. There actually was a power outage, so this print didn't complete 100%, but it got far enough that the loops were all closed, and I was still able to get a really cool single piece of fabric. I really love how this came out, especially with these colors. I'm using Matterhacker's Pro PLA in burgundy, gold, black, and white. I also printed out this second version using their blonde yellow PLA, and I think that gives it a really beautiful autumn theme. By the way, if you have a 3D printer, all these files are going to be free to download and print at myminifactory.com, so make sure to check out the link in the description, because you're going to want to print these. The last thing I wanted to try out was printing this same fabric, but a lot larger. So I made this second version that's nearly the same, but it's almost twice as large. Just like the smaller version, I printed out several tiles like this, that way I could fit it all on my printer, and then I stitched them all together to make a really big quilt. Okay, prepare to be extremely satisfied. Yeah, this thing is just super fun to play with. I have not been able to take my hands off of it since I first printed them out. I also printed out those edge models again, so this is really just a giant version of the other model. Of course, closing these larger loops with the 3D pen is going to take a bit more time and a bit more material, but it worked out just as well. In this case, I just used the blade from my Ulfa cutter to separate the two parts, just because it was the perfect size. Here it is all finished up, and not surprisingly, it's pretty darn awesome. It's interesting that in one direction it folds pretty well, but if you fold it the other way, it kind of holds its shape in an arc. And if you stack it just right, it'll stand up on its own, creating these really cool abstract sculptures. I also noticed that this fabric scatters light in a really cool way when the sun hit it through the window and I had all these little triangles dancing around my room. It also casts a really cool shadow, so this stuff has all kinds of interesting properties that are going to be really fun to play around with. And of course, I could pretty much do this forever. Alright guys, so that's pretty much what I've come up with so far with this 3D printed fabric idea, and I think some of the concepts were really successful, like this one. And I'm thinking this would be really cool to make a 3D printed cap, but as you saw, there's also maybe some non-fashion uses for this 3D printed fabric, like this bowl, or who knows what else. I'm hoping you guys can come up with some cool ideas and share them with me through the new Make Anything Creative network that I've created over at my website, makeanything.design. Make sure to check that out, share your ideas and inspiration regarding this project or anything that you're working on. It's been really fun. I want to thank the people who have shared their work so far. It's nice to see what everyone else is up to. And of course, I've got to thank my sponsor, Squarespace, for giving me the power to make this really cool Make Anything website without spending way too much time on it. They have all these pre-made templates that let you make still pretty customized websites. So it's quick, it's easy, it looks really professional, and it doesn't cost an arm and a leg. If you're thinking of making a website, a blog, portfolio, online store, check out squarespace.com/makeanything, and you can get 10% off your first purchase on top of that free 14-day trial. All right, like I said, we'll keep working on this 3D printed fabric together, but that's it for today. So until next time, I'm Devin, this is Make Anything. Don't forget to stay inspired. Yes.